What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Selena. For those of you who don't know, for those of you who do know, gang, welcome back. How you doing? I'm glad you guys are back. I came up with this orangey look. I don't know what I'm gonna call it yet. I should call it Tangerine Dreams, right? I really just did it because my nails, I did them orange, so I was like, ooh, orange nails, orange me, let's do it all orange, orange it up. That's how I got to this look right here. Before the rest of the video continues, stop right now, press that subscribe button, hit that like button once you're done watching the video, and turn on your post notifications so you guys don't miss any posts when I post them up. Also, comment some comments. I like to read comments. I may or may not randomly give away an eyeshadow palette and some lipsticks to a random comment. I don't know. Maybe. Yo, that liner though, wow. Really hopped in my bag real quick, okay? Okay, now that y'all all the way in my face, how you doing? This is my skin, which, by the way, I'm putting up a skincare routine video in the same week of this various video upload. Gotcha. So prime, I will be using my Photo Focus concealer. I'm just gonna place some on my eye. To blend it out, I will be taking my Morphe G38 and I'm just gonna blend out the concealer and disperse it evenly. Instead of using actual eyeshadow, I wanna put down a real opaque base for like this bright red orange. So first we're gonna be taking this Fenty liquid lipstick in the shade Hot Lips. I'm taking just a little bit, just like these. Now I'm going to begin to put this right where my crease is, right here. I know it's scary, it's like, oh my god, you're putting lipstick on your eyelid, but trust me guys, mama know what she doing. And then you wanna spread it out with the brush and kinda keep it in that round motion of the way you have your eyelid set up right now. And just a forewarning, we are using a lot of different oranges from different palettes. You don't have to do it like that. You can entirely do it with whatever colors you like. But today, we are going to be using oranges from different palettes. So the next palette that we're going to be using is going to be the Nubian 2 by Juvia's Place. And we are going to be going in with the color Morocco. I'm going to be taking that on my Morphe Y17. Right over where I put the lipstick, I'm going to be placing this Morocco color. It's kind of a darker orange so that it matches. You can definitely be generous with the application of this shadow because you do want to build up the color in a way so that it is noticeable and you can see it. Okay, so now that you got your eye kind of looking a little bit like this, we are now going to cut the crease, and I'm going to be using the same Wet n Wild concealer that we used to prime. We're going to take the concealer, trace out that line, and we're going to stop it right here because I don't want to take away from the orange color that's back there. I kind of just want to cover up this area. Like I told you guys, when you're doing these things and you're using concealer, you want the liquid bases to be completely dried down so that it doesn't interfere with your dry bases that are already placed there. And I'm now going to be going in with a different palette, the Morphe Day Slayer palette. This is the 15D, and we will be going in with the color In the Crease. Just going right above where the concealer stops because I do want that to be more blended in. So what you guys can do is build with the shadow and just lightly tap all around, just like that. And then next we'll be going in with the color Sorbet from the Kylie Royal Peach palette. Just taking a little bit of peach sorbet, and I'm also going to be wetting my brush just a little bit. When you wet matte shadows, they kind of come up a little more opaque than they would normally. You want this color to go down there and be very visible because it is going to be the base to the glitter that we will be putting on. Next, what we are going to be doing is going to be adding glitter. The glitter that we're going to be using today is called Electric Coraline by Violet Balls. I'm gonna be taking it on, not like a flat concealer brush, I'm gonna be taking it on just a packer brush. This is the Crown Mini Chisel Fluff. It is a packer brush that looks just like this. And this is just gonna allow me to put down the glitter in a way where it's kind of not sticking the way it would with a concealer brush, and it's kind of just like dusting on, and I'm not adding any product, so nothing to make the glitter stick on, because if it was to do that, it would just create a different type of effect, and that's not what I want. Okay, so now that we have the effect that we have going on this eye, next is to do liner. I have no idea how this is gonna go, to be honest with you, because it took me so long to do this liner. When it comes to doing liner, this is usually the liner that I preferably use. I usually start from right here, knowing that I want to go up, so I face it towards my brow, and on this side, I'll just look at it again. You see where the curve of my hooded ass eye is? I want to start that on this side, so right where the curve of the hood is, a little past it, I'll do the same on this side. So now that we got the liner down, I'm pretty happy with it. I think it matches up with the other one. If it don't, oh well. Next, I'm gonna be going in with my Voluminous Lash Paradise mascara. And then for lashes today, Carla came out with some new lashes, so I'm hype as fuck. Like, you guys know I love my Carla J Glam lashes, and today we will be using the lashes in the style Mykonos. They're just amazing. Like, I just love them. I just love them. I have no other words. I'm just like so proud of my friend for just like doing so well, because I love these freaking lashes. Like, damn, Carla, you really hopped in your bag, sis. Hopped in it, took it home, left out the Birkin store, like, girl. Okay, so I'm gonna go and do my under eye off camera, and then I'll come back on camera to finish the rest of the face. Alright, so I went and did my under eye off camera. Guys, just so you know, every time I do my under eye, I just mimic whatever I did on the upper half of my eye and do the same on the lower bottom part of my eye. Next, I will be going in with my Clinique Moisture Surge Concentrate. This stuff is bomb as fuck. So I'm putting this on prior to makeup application because it's important. And I'm just gonna rub that onto my skin. Of course, it's not a video unless I'm using my Tatcha. So I will be using up my Tatcha The Silk Canvas Primer. And this Tatcha primer is really bomb too, guys. Like, really bomb. And it smells mad. Today I will be using the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation in the shade Caramel. I will be taking my Morphe Y7, my Dome Kabuki brush, and I will be using the Wet n Wild on there. But this applicator on this Wet n Wild thing looks like this, and it's a spatula, so I'm just gonna... Hopefully this is my color. Damn, it looks kind of dark. But we shall see. Let's see if we can make it work. Okay, so because I'm not entirely sure that I am 1000% that caramel color, I am going in with a little bit of golden beige in the same exact foundation. I'm just using it as a mixer, I guess you can say. Okay, so on the color, so far, so good. I love the way this foundation looks. I've used this before. It's not like I've not used it before. I also haven't used it in a long time. I know it's good though. Today we will also be going in with the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Concealer. And I am in the shade Light Medium Beige. And I'm just gonna highlight where I normally do. That's the only thing I will say. I do not like the applicator on this. But it also is just like every other concealer. I think I just love the Shape Tape one. I love the doe foot applicator for everything, but like a big doe foot. This is like a doe toe. It's not like a doe foot. Okay, so I didn't get to grab the Photo Focus or any other Wet n Wild product that would be like for my contour shade. So I'm just gonna go in with my Maybelline Fit Me in Cafe to add my cream contour. So next, for my mist today, I'm gonna be using the Rose Water Infused Hydra Spritz. This is from the Creme Shop. I got this in a goodie bag from a masterclass that I went to, but they do sell this on their site for $12, and it's really good. I love it. I use it up more on my clients. I don't really use it on myself. That's probably the only sucky part, but you know, I don't care. Whatever. It is whatever it is. Going in with my G38 to blend that out. Now we will be going in with my Maybelline Fit Me powder in light medium. You guys know I love this stuff. It is a very affordable face today, so I figured why not use the affordable powder, right? To set my face, and I'm taking that on my It's My Ray number 1 brush with Beach Cosmetics. Okay, so I wasn't able to pick up any Wet n Wild translucent powder, which I don't even think Wet n Wild has translucent powder, but I could be wrong. I don't know. I'm not sure. I will be going in with the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Press Compact Powder. I heard really, really good things about this powder, so we shall see. And I got the shade Golden Tan, so I'm just going to use that to brush away everything else that's on my face, I guess. You know, always other people use these powders. Next, I will be going in with my NYX Matte Bronzer, and this is in the shade Deep Tan. This bronzer is actually really good. It's the bronzer I used to use before I started walling and using my Gimme Sun all the time and using my Precision's formula. And for blush, I will be using my MAC Peaches blush. You know I love this blush. And then today I will be using my College of Glam Liquid Illuminator Drops as a base for my highlights. I haven't used this in a very long time, but you can see she's had her use. So I'm just taking some of it on my Beauty Blender, and I'm just gonna rub it on my skin. Look at that. Instant boom. You see why I love Carla and College of Glam all together? Like, sis, be the fuck knowing. Look at that. And that's without me adding another highlighter on it. And I literally used nothing. Like, I used the smallest tiny bit. And then lastly, shout out to me, because I did not do this on purpose. I will be using the Wet n Wild Golden Flower Crown highlight as my highlighter today. Oh, bitch. She blings. Oh my god. I didn't mean to put that much. Jesus Santo. Look, yo. Nah. Honestly, I'm done. I'm done, Wet n Wild. You have these edges. They're leaving. You know why? Because look at this. This face. And you want to know what's the best thing about everything that's here? It's just that Wet n Wild is cheap. Wet n Wild is like drugstore. You guys can find all of this stuff. And I heard that they were extending the line for the Photo Focus foundation, so shout out to my morenitas. Y'all be able to get that too. I am like, I just can't. And of course, to bring it all together, we're gonna go ahead and spray some of my Tatcha Luminous Dewy Skin Mist. Okay, so, oh my god, yeah, guys, I also wanted to tell you guys about this lip oil that I've been using lately. I'm a person who definitely needs to use lip comfortable stuff. If it's too sticky, it's a dub. If it's too clumpy, like here in the inside of my mouth, it's a dub. If it bothers me in any way in between being out in festivities or even just staying home and taking pictures, it's a dub. I'm not using it, but I have found something that is really incredible. This is by NK Makeup, and it's called a Pure Lip Oil, and this is in the flavor coconut. And this is what it looks like. I don't even know if NK has like a brand or anything like that, but I love these lip oils. You can find them. I found it in Bliss Beauty. Bliss Beauty is a beauty supply that sells Morphe, Crown, NYX, Gerard Cosmetics, anything you name, they have. Look at the application of this. It's literally just an oil. That's it. But, and I'll have it on all day. And I kid you not, guys, like, it doesn't clump up, it doesn't get nasty on me, nothing looks bad. It's really, really good. Like, really, really good. I'm gonna be going in with the LA Girl Auto Liner and Lasting Brown. And next, I'm gonna be going in with my No Shade lipstick by Dose of Colors and the collab with Desi and Katie. Okay, and to top it off, I'm gonna go ahead and take some of my NYX Fortune Cookie lip gloss and put it right over the top. Okay guys, so this is the final look. I hope you're living and loving, because I'm living and I'm loving. I love. I think it looks beautiful. It looks a lot more put together now that I see it out, because it was just kind of like a thought and I was kind of just going over my nails, and I actually love the way that it came out. So I hope you guys did too. As you already know, before you go, please remember to push that subscribe button, press that like button if you enjoyed the video, and also don't forget to come back, because the next video that I'm going to be posting this week, I'm going to be talking about giveaway, and you don't want to miss that. Trust me that you need what's in that giveaway. The giveaway is popping, okay? Have a great rest of your evening wherever you guys are, and I hope you come back for more. See you next time. It's a tick, time's up. Hey, you gon' have to climb it if you want it. Burning rubber, burning through these rubbers is exhausting. Drop, hot, baby girl, it's CrossFit. I'ma grab your body, hips, hey. I'm flicking my wrist like I'm a bishop. Diamonds on my chest like a bishop. And these lines right here ain't no pickup. These lines right here gon' really, really make you fuck this.